side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. He kicks off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20, makes it to the 22-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. And he's hit immediately. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Complete. He's got space to work.
Good job here by the receiver. Look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
He goes out of bounds at the 41. Open receiver, no good.
That's just a great play to separate the ball from the receiver. He'll be feeling that hit tomorrow.
It's third and five. Ball on the 41. And they make the stop around the 34-yard line.
Brad, you can really feel and sense the energy coming from the sidelines right now. They know how important it is to pick up first downs. And the coaches right now are showing the excitement that they have and yelling out the next play for the offense. But clearly, the offensive coordinator very happy about the execution on that last play.
Locked down at the 22. Quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. From the 22-yard line, second down. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Quarterbacks just love this scenario. He had his man one-on-one on a corner route versus man coverage, and you just saw it. It results in an easy first down.
The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
False start, offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a five-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. Touchdown, Washington State. Call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
And he hits the PAT. A 10-play, 83-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Ducks know that they can give this guy the ball, Kirk, 25, 30 times a game, and that's great. And if it's working, that's perfect. But also, as a defensive team, you look at him and you go, we worry about him too much, we could get burned somewhere else.
Well, the defensive coach has told us this week the first thing that they have to do is stop this running game. And when you're convinced you have to stop the running game, you leave your defensive backs, especially your corners, isolated one-on-one in coverage. And if they're smart, they'll try to take advantage of that and try to make some big plays in the passing game, maybe early, and then go back to old reliable, and that's running the football.
Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. And he's taken down at the 45. Almost 6 yards on the play action. He makes it to the 45-yard line. Tries to buy some time. He's at the 40. They'll bring him down around the 30-yard line. Big yardage there on the quarterback run.
He dropped back to throw the ball and saw that no one was open. He just took off.
Quick throw, and he's got his man again. And he's tackled around the 24-yard line. Nice run up the middle. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 18-yard line. Throws it in a hurry. That's a great tackle at the 15.
Before it got started, that was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
This isn't much more than an extra point. It's up, and he got it.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Oregon, ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 3. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 22-yard line. This offense just torched the defense through the air with a great passing attack on their last drive.
This offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receiver. Because, again, they put so much time in trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller.
Washington State holds a 4-point lead. And he hauls it in. Tackle made around the 36-yard line. Quick out to his receiver, and he tackles him hard at the 50.
There you go. Good read by the quarterback to give the offense a new set of downs. If the defense wants to line up and man, work that slant route until they stop it.
Get to that quicker, and he is drilled at the 43-yard line. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. throw, and he's got his receiver again. He's taken down
right around the 26-yard line.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Complete and pushed out of bounds behind the line. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry, and he hits him hard at the 20. It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. That makes it fourth and four. The kick is up, and it sails through the uprights. Hang on, everybody, because it looks like they came ready to play today. Washington State's lead is a touchdown. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Brought down in the open field. Their own 37-yard line. Third down. He steps up. Quick strike to the receiver. He's tackled in the open field. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. He gets it up, and he splits the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Washington State is up by four. Quick pass. Fumble. And no one can get it. It bounces out of bounds. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. It out to about the 37-yard line. With the pass incomplete, the defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 37. Looks middle, got his back. Very good tackle in space. About 5 yards that time on the throw.
Not a bad play. They gained 5 yards out of it. Keep moving the defense back.
Looks to his back, and he's got him again. That last pass got him only a yard.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. And down he goes at the 23-yard line.
Oregon's coaching staff, I've got a thing going into halftime, and we're getting close right now, Kirk. They've got to do something different. What they had planned with their star running back's just not working today.
Well, I think the continuity between a coaching staff and a quarterback and an offense is tested. Their star player is not having a great game. They're losing this football game. I think now, as we're close to this half, now's when you start to think about what other ways can we attack this defense. And then maybe eventually we get back to our star running back. But in the meantime, let's try to find some other ways to attack to be able to put points up.
His way to the 40-yard line. Got a man open. Bad pass. From their own 40-yard line. Second down. Zips it to the back. Tackle around the 48-yard line. Now he's scrambling, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
Both defenses really played well so far.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Washington State is up 4. He rifles it. Caught by the sophomore, and he's level at the 43. From the 43-yard line, second down. Pass in daylight. Tackled inside the 5-yard line. The Cougars use their second timeout.
Go, go, go.
Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. And he tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a T-shirt that says finish, finish, whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to their opponent's territory.
And they make the stop, the 36-yard line.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Over the middle to his tailback. Locked down at the 44-yard line.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
Going deep. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal.
Huge play for both the quarterback and receiver, but it all starts with the big fellas up front who provided the time to get the quarterback a chance to throw.
He's going to try and scramble. Nice move, and he scores. Hits the PAT. A four-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense is looking more and more explosive.
So our score, 17-13. Oregon to kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 28-yard line. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and great drive last time out. Washington State holds a 4-point lead. Here's a throw. I don't think he got anything on that. Quarterback all by himself from the backfield with 5 wideouts. And he's taken down at about the 43-yard line. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. They'll bring him down around the 39-yard line. So with the half ending, they're just going to try to put 3 points up on the board. Kicks up, and he just drilled it from long range. We've played a half. The Cougars in front, 20-13.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half, and boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herbstreit's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, we've got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
And And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Both these offenses stepping up and answering the bell. Who's going to blink first here?
Exactly right. I've just been impressed with the way they've been able to execute. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on them. Anytime you're feeling that the other offense can put points up on the board, there's a tendency to want to press. Neither one has done that up to this point, and right now it's going to come down to who can continue to execute, put points up.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he's tackled at the 34. Gets out to about the 44-yard line.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Concentration lapse right there. The coaches will be giving them an earful for it, too.
From the 41-yard line. First down. Made at the 41. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. That brings up second and nine. He has some room.
Defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
From the 30-yard line, it's first down. Now he tries to buy some time. He's taken down around the 23-yard line. Gets out to around the 15.
Push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
Ball inside the 10-yard line. It's second down. The Ducks running back sidelined earlier with that injury. Right now, though, it looks like he's warming up, trying to get back in the ball game. And up the middle, and he's stuck. Throw. And down he goes at the 5-yard line. It's fourth down. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. It's up, and it's through the uprights. Oregon ready to kick this one off. He'll take it from the 2. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series.
Washington State is up by 4. Quick out to his receiver. He's tackled around the 32-yard line. Steps up and goes down.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
Third and 9. Ball on the 26. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Well, the defense stood tall there.
Well, the defense did what they had to do to get 3 and out and now get the offense back on the field.
He gets hit out of bounds at about the 41.
There's still plenty of time to keep offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Fires it out. He's pushed out of bounds at the 47.
That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Throws it in a hurry. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
That makes it 3rd and 3.
He tackles him for a loss.
It's a good surge by the defense. They really disrupted the timing on that play and gave him no chance to get the first.
Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Washington State is up 4. Slings it. Tackle at the 40-yard line. And he hits him hard at the 46-yard line.
That brings him 2nd and 5.
Can they pull off the upset? Well, we're going to find out as we head into the fourth quarter. 2016 Cougars. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Throws it away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From the 48-yard line, 2nd down. And they got it.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Thank you. Washington State holds a four-point lead. Hit immediately. He's got 300 yards passing now.
You can tell the quarterback's done a really good job of preparing because he's read the defense like a pro all day long.
Quick throw out to the receiver.
Sack him. The pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Fires out quickly to the tailback. Brought down at the 5.
That makes it first and goal.
Down, Washington State. He splits the uprights with the extra point. An 11-play, 80-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
You know, you could throw the football as well as these guys can. You don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient in throwing the ball.
He's to the 20. Across the 30. Tackles the 33-yard line. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Out to around the 45. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
See a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
Now he's scrambling. Decides to tuck it in and he's got space. Dives forward. Scramble. And he's taken down at the 23-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. Knocked out of bounds at the 21-yard line. Third and 5 coming up. Ball on the 21-yard line. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And they push him out around the 6-yard line. Touchdown, Oregon!
2 in this situation. They got it. So with just over 2 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, our score, 27-24, Washington State. Oregon lines up for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And what a game it's been for this quarterback, Kirk.
Well, he's putting up huge numbers, and I think you can go back and look at every throw that he's made. It's like a human highlight film in one football game. The thing that surprised me today is that we know about his ability to throw the football, but here's a guy that can also hurt you with his feet if he has to.
We'll see what else he has in store for this defense as they look to tack on more points. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And it'll bring him down at the 37. Oregon's going to take their first time out of the half. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. Just over 2 minutes in the game. To that quickly, and he's immediately tackled. Oregon's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Passes it to the middle of the field, and he's tackled right around the 42-yard line. From the 42-yard line, first down. Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. Up the middle. Runs outside for a nice gain.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
Just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. Washington State holds a field goal lead. Great one to win, a really tough one to lose. 27-24, Washington State. So that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.